back to another video. This seems to be becoming a bit of a thing now, starting the videos off in the truck. You will be pleased to know, guys, we have won a bit of salvage down at Sandwich Copart. And also, quite a lot of you will be pleased to know that it's actually a van that we've won. Quite a lot of you in previous videos have said, why don't you buy a van? I mean, we always buy what is available, and we have bought vans in the past before the YouTube channel. So we are pretty much just coming up for the gate, but there is a bit of traffic. As soon as we get in there, guys, and get it paid for, we'll come back with an update on it. We'll see you shortly. And again, fingers crossed, there ain't a massive queue, because it is Friday and it's normally the worst day to come down here. So there's a few people in the queue, but we get over there, get it paid for, and then we'll wait till it gets loaded up and then do a little bit on it. Here we go, guys. 2016 Peugeot Partner. We get it loaded up, so they don't like us filming, and then we do a walk around on it. So guys, check this out. To quite a lot of you, this will look destroyed. And it, to be honest, straight off the bat, it doesn't look good. But guys, this is a 16 reg van, and our plan is with this is to purely upgrade the van that Chris has got. His is a 12, this is a 16. It's a lot newer, and again, to you guys, this will look destroyed, but you can see how bad it really does look. But to us, guys, this is not bad at all. It's been hit here very high up, and we have got all of these components to actually repair this van, including the windscreen, so it should turn out pretty well for us. We'll be repairing this, obviously we'll be documenting it on video, and then once this is complete, this will be Chris's new daily driver van, and we'll be cleaning his one up and advertising it for sale. And hopefully Chris will end up with this van, and the sale of his van are completely cover the cost of it. So basically, he's upgraded to a van quite a few years newer for no money. That is the plan with this van. I'm going to jump back in the truck and show you how much we paid for it. Well, guys, this is the interesting bit. We knew that because we had quite a lot of those parts, we was going to bid that little bit extra for it, what nobody else would bid, especially with it being a non-runner. We knew that it was going to be worth the money. So we actually put in a bid for £1,600 on that van, and we actually won it for £900, which is unbelievable. They counterbid us £1,350, and as you know, once I make my bid, if I win it for that price, I believe I've won it for that price. So I stuck to original bid. And then, sorry guys, I'm just going to fold this over because it has got all my, no, it hasn't got my details on it. So with the fees, £1,280. Guys, that was cheap. We are like well happy with the price of that, and we can't wait to really change that fuse box, because you can see it in the background there, the fuse box is destroyed. We'll change that fuse box and we'll get this all up and running on the button, get it starting and driving, and then we'll start the process of stripping off the damaged parts and investigating it and start carrying out the repairs. Let us know what you think of today's bargain in the comment section. We're, to say the least, over the moon with the price of it, and happy that they did actually let us have it. So no complaints there. We'll head back to the yard, guys, get it unloaded, and probably do a bit more of a walk around on the van. So we just got back to base, guys. We've whipped the wheel off, we've got the spare off of Chris's van. We're going to chuck that on, we're going to pump up the tyre the other side and try and get it so that it is all on its wheels, and then we'll get it off the back of the truck, take it into the yard and do a full assessment of the damage and where we're going to go moving forward with it. So guys, it is the next day now. We have got the new van in the yard ready, and we have put the parts van right next to it. What we're going to do today, we're not 100% that we're going to be able to do it in this video, but we are certainly going to try our hardest. We're going to remove that front bumper, remove that bonnet, remove some other damaged parts, And then we are actually going to get involved in trying to get the wires repaired that are ripped out and damaged. And we have noticed this morning that the ECU, you can see the prongs in there are bent, and this plug has actually ripped out of that. So what we want to try and do is get that all repaired, get the new one in there off of the parts van. We've got it all here, we've got everything ready to go. Chris has already popped the fuse box out, I believe, so this component, we've got that sitting in there ready to go. So basically, yeah, we're going to strip back, just try and tidy it all up a bit, and then get these wires fixed, and hopefully just in this video get it running. And we are going to be removing like the bonnet, the bumper, etc, etc, and then we'll go, if we do get it running, we'll then start stripping back and getting all of the damaged parts removed off of the van. Let's stop waffling on, get involved, and try and get this running today. So moving along quite nicely there, guys. We both lifted the bonnet off, went round, removed that headlight, which isn't broken, which has saved us a few pounds. I've gone ahead and removed the front panel, the radiators, and a few other little bits of damaged plastic. You can see we've got the bin quite full there now. So yeah, I've just been getting on with doing that, getting all the horrible broken stuff removed. The scuttle panel's gone. This broken air intake here has gone that goes into the cabin, we've removed that. Chris has straightened out, there was a couple of bent pins on this ECU. You would have seen it in my first bit of recording there. We have got an ECU and complete lock set out of the parts van, but we would really not like to change all of that if this survived. So the ECU itself never actually got hit, it had a cage around it, and there was just a few bent pins in here, but Chris just went in, straightened them all out. He's plugged the plug back in, which is the one he's got in his hand there, and it actually fits perfect. But he's found quite a few damaged wires there, and the actual plug's damaged itself. So what he's actually going to do is he's cut one off the parts car, he's going to stagger those in and completely fit a new plug with the locking mechanism on it as well. So fingers crossed, guys, we should be able to get this fired up today with a bit of luck. We are going to just carry on, get as much of it done as we can, and I'll come back soon as we've got another update. Just wanted to show this bit, guys, for those of you that don't actually know. Just there, that little silver pin, and that's the airbag release on these little Berlingos or Peugeot partner vans. And literally I always put a little bit of weight on the steering wheel and then just push that pin and out it pops. That simple, really, really easy to do. We'll get that unplugged and completely remove that. Little bit of an update, guys. Didn't want to fill it up with too much time lapse. The vacuum pump there, one of these fittings had snapped off. We had a spare. I've gone ahead, bolted that on. It was just 210 mils. As you would have seen there on that time lapse, Chris has really been cracking on with that. He's just down to the original broken wires now. All of the others have been rejoined. He soldered them up, heat shrunk them, so we're moving along with that. I did start looking in just to see if anything else was broken, and I noticed that this plug on the actuator was broken. But when we do look into the turbo, as you can see, a couple of the fins in there are bent and damaged. Even though it is flowing freely, we do have a turbo, the original one off of Chris's flooded engine, and it's absolutely fine. We've got a new actuator for it, etc. So we have got all these bits, even down to like that fuse box there that's broken. The actual casing, we have all that on this van. I say we have got everything that we're going to need. The original fuse box there, that's quite, it's got a couple of little dents in it there. It's not too bad, but again, we have a replacement, so we might as well fit that. So that's how we're getting on so far, and so good. And the weather does seem to be holding off, so we'll carry on as we are, and hopefully we will manage to get it done. We have been really, really busy on it. We have put the other fuse box in there. The ECU's all back on, wired up the best it can. We've had to put the jump pack on it. I think this is on its way out, so we've got a battery on it as well. And we didn't want to try and start it without you guys being there as well. The air intake, we have put that on there just temporarily to plug everything in. Righto, Chris, you want to give that a go? Turning over all right. Cuts out on the key on its own. Do you want to give it one more go? Or? Just going to check the fuel pipes, guys, and then come straight back and spin it over again. But we are running out of light hours. It's about 5 o'clock, I believe, and it's starting to get dark, so fingers crossed, guys, we are trying. As you can see, guys, it is dark now. I've just run down the garage, got some more diesel, and we've just literally chucked a gallon of diesel in it. We've had to get another battery out, the one off the Jag, and we are ready to give it a last try. And if it doesn't work, then we will have to come back to it. Righto, mate, yeah, give that a go. Look at that. Oh, guys, that's fantastic. That sounds lovely as well. Quite a lot of water in, so I've cut that off, Chris. We're going to be getting involved and getting this all straightened out and panelled up. After the little MG video yesterday, we did run around and collect a few little bits for the van so that we could get it panelled up today. So we did manage to find a wing in colour. We have the bumper support, we have a front panel, the slam panel, water radiator, we already had the air comrade, two bonnet hinges in colour, and the headlight panel in colour. We also managed to purchase a damaged bonnet for only £20. And as you can see, it's got a crease on it here. And this lip here is all bent down. So Chris will be straightening that out later, and I am going to get that on video for you. He has already done a little bit off camera the other day when I wasn't around. He stripped out the brake servo and just basically cleaned up and removed everything out of this front turret section that he needs to, so that we can get the dozer on here today and get this damaged pulled out, straightened out, get all these brackets straightened out, have a pull on this post here, get the door off, basically pull it all apart, get it panelled up, get all the lines correct. We have got a bumper on order for it, and we are literally waiting for a bumper and a headlight. We do have everything else, and we're going to crack on and try and get that straightened out today. Chris is just drilling off that light panel, and I am just going to give this front mud guard for that bike, I'm just going to paint it the right colour because I need to get it up for sale now that it is completely finished. So it's going to be a little bit more time lapse, and then we'll come back when we start actually putting up the new panels and giving that turret a good pull. Obviously, we are going to be using the dozer today to pull out the front of this. We are going to pull the dozer out in a moment. So quite a lot of people would wonder what we are pushing off. We have done a video on this before when we repaired a car for somebody else, but the seal clamps, this is what we use. Instead of getting a jig out, it's quite soft on the front. We're not going to need it. So we've got the seal clamps on there. They've got four bolts in each of them. They're pinched right up to the seal really tight, both sides, and then we've got this solid iron bar running all the way through, and that will basically be what we are pushing off of. The end of the dozer will go on to that. The front of the dozer will be round here, and we'll start pulling that with the chains, and I'll come in as soon as we are doing that. We're just going to get it all set up. So we are going to try and get as much of this on camera as we can for you, but with a job like this, it is time consuming sometimes, where we have to keep moving the brackets around because it's got to be pulled in the right place. So I am hoping that this is going to work out quite well. Sorry, we're just dropping that down a little bit there. And we're actually going to film giving it a pull, and hopefully you can see some of it. So ready when you are, Chris. You will see me and Chris are both the other side of that chain there as well, because if that does ping off, you don't want it to whip you. But these clamps get tighter and tighter the more you pull. But so far, so good. Warning, we're going to be doing a bit of hammering as well. I'm going to pop it out the stack, right, not around the other side. Thank you. So this actually was the only damage on the van. Just here, it completely missed the chassis leg. It was purely just that little corner. What Chris was doing there, for those of you that don't know, he's actually beating the creased. He's actually hitting where it was creased. So once we let the chain go, it stays where it is. It will always move back a little bit, but it does prevent it from obviously crumpling straight back to where it was. I am going to pause for a minute while Chris has a good beat on it, and I'll come back once we're pulling it again. Really cracking on. Everything seems to be lining up lovely. This upright here, Chris actually has stuck that on there this morning and put a few screws in it. I will go around the back and show you. He lined it up with the actual paint marks and all the original spot welds, and actually just got a couple of screws holding it, bolted back in there to that bottom leg, and then obviously a few little screws in this panel. This panel he had to repair because we didn't get one yesterday. We didn't realise we was going to need one, but all in there is all coming together, and as you can see, that's all that's left of that damage. All this has come out perfectly as it should do, and even this is all really, really flat. Very, very good news, and saved cutting all that out and putting a new one in. So in a moment, we'll be moving on to these wing brackets. We need to get those straightened out, and then we can start lining up the wing, start working on the bonnet, start lining that up, getting the hinges on there. We'll just keep moving on. Hopefully, I'm showing enough. I know that a lot of people really, really do like to see all of it, and I would love nothing more than to be able to show it all, but you'd end up doing an 8-hour day with us on video, and I'm quietly confident it'd probably take a week to upload it. So hopefully, fingers crossed, if there is anything I have missed and you want to see it in the next videos, please feel free to drop it in the comment section. I always do read the comments. I don't always get time to reply, but I will read it, and it will be in my mind for next time. An update, I think. The front wing, Chris is just sticking that on there. Obviously, it is temporary, we are going to have to lift it off again. But if you look at the gap all the way down, it's completely uniform. And I said to Chris, that seems quite big, the gaps on this. He went, have a look at the other side. And then I went and had a look at his van, and they are exactly the same. The gap between that door and the side loading door is absolutely fine all the way down. I will walk round and just show you the other side. You've got that, again, big gap all the way down. So we will get them absolutely perfect when we line it up. I really have been cracking on with it today. And all of that is back just where it should be. And everything straightened out really, really nice. So Chris did say this wing has got a little bit of a tip outwards, so he's just going to undo that, bend the brackets back over. You can see it there. Can I just show that, Chris? Just there, see that's a bit higher there. So he's gonna have to basically twist this over that way by bending these brackets back over a little bit. Obviously the bonnet, when it was hit there, did just hit the edge of that wing and it's pushed that over. So we're gonna do that. Then we're gonna move on to fitting the bonnet hinges. Chris is gonna have a play around with that bonnet, try and repair that. And then we'll be fitting the bonnet, making sure it closes, etc., etc. But we really are steaming on today, and hopefully we'll get the majority of it done. So what do you think of that? I mean, it's been one long day, but the majority, the worst parts of this job are complete. They're done. In the next video, we'll be welding in the panels, then going round sealing them up, painting them, starting the bodywork. Chris has straightened out that bonnet, done a brilliant job of it. We had an old light out the other van that's actually got a big crack in the back, so we use that as a template. And as you can see, he's repaired that bonnet. It's going to need a very, very minimal skim of filler in there and a little paint up. We've just rested that front bumper backing on there just to see what it looks like. Obviously it does all need pulling into place, but everything lined up absolutely fine. We've had to stick the mold grips on it just to bring it in a little bit because we haven't welded the bracket on yet. But overall, we're well chuffed with what we got done today. We're going to be having a windscreen fitted. We're literally just waiting on parts. Otherwise, you know us, we would have been here now fitting the other headlight, fitting the bumper, and we would have completely panelled it up. But Chris has done all that by eye without the headlight. There wasn't really a lot that you could get wrong. He said it was literally getting rid of that crease down there and straightening up this side of it here. But if there is any minor tweaks, once that headlight comes, they can all be done very, very easily because nothing is welded in. But overall, we're quite chuffed with what we got done today. We're going to be concentrating on fitting the new turbo. If you remember in the last video, the plug's broken off it and quite a few of the fins inside are bent. We've got one with very, very low mileage come off of the parts van, so we might as well just stick that on there. Chris did get a little bit ahead of me this morning and fit that brake servo, but to be fair, you're not going to be able to see it in there anyway. So we're going to crack on, get that done. I've been on the phone to the windscreen fitter as well. Hopefully we can get him in this video. Then we'll be moving on to welding up this section here that Chris screwed in last week. And then I suppose we'll start the process of doing the paintwork and panelling it up. So let's stop waffling on, get involved and try and knock this out today. That's quite straightforward to do. And there's the original one. We can have a proper look inside it now, and you can see it's actually probably only one or two of those that are bent, but we don't want to straighten it out, not when we've got one anyway. It does turn freely. That's the bent one there, Chris, isn't it? Yeah. But you know, we've got this one here, it's done absolutely 0 miles, like 3,000. So I've just got to whip that oil feed off, and then we'll put that straight back on. It's not the oil feed, that one, sorry, it's the return. Thank you.
as usual, very, very productive there. It was quite fiddly to do, to get the turbo off. We had to undo these two 10 mils, undo this, move it out of the way, and you got two 10 mils under there for the heat shield, one here, remove that, and then separate the turbo, and there's four bolts that actually bolt the turbo to the manifold, and a couple of oil feeds, oil in and oil out. New actuators on there, the original one, we did separate that for some reason a little while back, and we've connected all that up. You would have seen Chris right in the camera there. He come over and I completely forgot we was recording, but basically he was just going around test fitting everything, the fuse box, etc. He was just putting it all back in, but the brake master cylinder, the servo, is all back in there now, so that's all good. The battery tray all lines up absolutely perfect on its bolts. Not that it was hit that far back anyway. If, like I said in the video before, it was hit across here. So really, really moving on with it. What, we'd be moving on to the welding shortly, Chris, won't we?
Yeah, I think we're just gonna
move on to the welding, start prepping it, doing a bit of paint, and then we'll probably stop it there, let it dry overnight, come back the next day and start fitting it up, I think.
Yep.
Yeah. Again, it goes so fast on time lapse, and I really do apologize if you don't get to see a lot of it, but we have to crack on, and it's really difficult to keep cutting in and out. Hopefully you did see enough. You would have just seen there that we was literally running round, sheeted it up, masked it up. Chris then went round, sealed it, primed it, and literally just put a bit of paint on there. We're going to be doing a small skim in here where Chris knocked it out, getting that flatted off, getting some primer on it, so that is all done and ready. Down here, Chris has just whipped that wheel off. He's took the little dent out that was in the back of the arch here, was very small. Now he's going to make a start on this front one, and then obviously we'll be prepping that and getting that in primer. I think that is about it on this van. There's a little bit on the edge of the bonnet as well, I forgot about. Obviously, if you remember in the last video, Chris, this was actually bent over. Chris knocked it dead straight, but there is some little dents in here. So we're going to be prepping that. Obviously, a little bit of filler and some primer on that as well. And then this can go off to the paint shop. And once it comes back, it will be completely finished. We'll wash it, valet it, crunch the numbers, and that will be the last video. And we'll be putting it out for sale. I did mention that we was going to be selling this van, and Chris is keeping his other one. And quite a lot of you do keep reaching out to me about vehicles, saying, how much is it? Where's it going for sale? When's it going to be for sale? Guys, I only put the vehicles on Instagram, and I would never give a price or advertise them until they are completely buttoned up. So as soon as this is done, I will be putting it on Instagram for sale. Let's get on with the job in hand. We'll be right back. seen there on that time lapse. Chris just really made short work of that. Shouldn't take us too long now. He's give that a coat of filler, knock that down, then he'll probably, that is going to want another little skim in it after, isn't it? So we'll need another little skim in there once that is knocked down. This one here, we'll knock that down. Should come out really nice, that, because he managed to get the majority of it out. Just had a couple of like minor little dents in it. And then the back arch there, and it did have a little dent there, but you know, Chris, he wanted it bang on, so he's filled that as well. So both of them are done. And he is round here with some panel wipe. And look at the difference. He's just gone along and removed all of the tar and little bits of, you know, road debris that sticks to it over the years. And it looks like new now along there. And he's just going along getting the rest of them out. Quite a lot of people did reach out when we done that last video. Chris, see that little bit of glue there?
Yep.
Can you just get that off for us? Let's have a look at that now. So as you can see how good it brings it up. And quite a lot of you did say to me in the last video, Rob, what was that you used? And the answer to that is, you can actually use three different products. But that's what I was using. The U-Pole, just basic degreaser panel wire. But you can also use thinners, obviously not on an older car because it will pull the paint off. We are talking quite old, but for all these modern cars, you can use thinners, petrol or panel wipe to get any of the stickers or any of the road tar or anything like that off. I've used petrol quite a lot of times. It is quite smelly and you do need to wash it down after, but if you haven't got no thinners or panel wipe, it does work absolute wonders. But with the panel wipe, that all comes off as well, and it doesn't take the shine off your paint, so you can just give it a wash after and it does come up lovely. But I will put the link for that panel wipe in the description so that if you did want to get any, you could. That's a little top piece of the front grill there, Chris, isn't it?
Yeah.
Would it have a little mark in it?
Yeah.
So this little top piece of the grill, guys, it had a little bit of a wave in it here. So Chris got out as much as he could, and he's put a skim in there, and he's just literally rubbing that down now. Is that your second coat in there?
No.
That's the first coat, so it possibly may need one more. With this one, he rubbed it all back. He found a low spot here and a low spot here, so he's gone again with that as well. And then round here, that's the second coat. And on that back arch, that will be the final coat. He has knocked that down and then put a little bit back over the top of that. But off camera, earlier on, I was explaining about Chris getting all them bits and pieces off. He actually went ahead and done the whole side of the van. Look how nice that come up. There's not even really any signs of the sign writing. Normally you have to mop these right up. There's a few little marks on there. It needs a wash, but he's got every single black dirty mark off of it. There is a little tiny pin dent here. He's not going to be filling that. You'd have to paint most of the quarter to lose it. So he's going to knock that out and it'll be barely noticeable. But you can see where he's done the quarter and he hasn't done the door. And it come out absolutely beautiful. He is really moving along with it and it's all going to be quite quick. So in just one day, from this morning to the end of the day, Chris has knocked that out. That filler work is completely done and it is ready for some primer. He has just pulled it out, swept all the floor, tidied up a bit so that he can start the process of bagging it up to get some primer on it. So we've got that little bit there. The A-post, as we expected, come out absolutely lovely. He did manage to knock quite a lot of that out anyway. Sorry about the wind noise. That back wheel arch there, absolutely perfect. And again round there. So he's done that in a day. We get it bagged up, get it in primer. We have got obviously two at the paint shop now, being the little Fiat 500. He did send me a couple of pictures of it this morning actually, and said that it's in primer and it's ready to paint. And when he sent me the pictures, I had to ring him up and say, actually, mate, you know, you forgot to do the holes in the back bumper. I haven't got parking sensors, and it's just another expense putting them on. So he's had to stall painting it today so that he can do those holes in the bumper, and then he'll be painting it tomorrow. So hopefully that will be back later next week. We got the Fiesta, that will be back by the end of the week. All we got to do is put that together. We got the little van to be getting on with and mock up. We got the Sierra Cosworth, hopefully from Wednesday, all of the MOT stations will be open. So we'll be doing a video on that. And obviously my new bike build, I'll be cracking on and getting a load done on that. So plenty to look forward to this week and next week. And not to forget, sorry, the old LSE. We need to get back onto that. So I had to go off there while Chris was doing this. I had a couple of you guys actually come out to look at the Focus and bought it. So he's primed that all up. He's let it go off. He's put a guy coat on there. So now that'll just need flatten off and that will be ready for paint. Again, same with the A-pillar. Back exactly how it should be. And then moving on to this rear wheel arch. That's all ready to go as well. So really moved on with that. Literally all there is left to do is flat that off. And as soon as we get either the Fiat 500 or the Fiesta back from paint, this one can go up, get done, and that's another one wrapped up. So it is looking like we're gonna get quite a few bits wrapped up this week. Fingers crossed, this is one of them. We had a little chat and decided that we've got to get quite a few of these knocked out, but I've come in this morning. This is the next day. And Chris has pulled his truck in. I said, are you doing that bit on the roof that went rusty, mate? And he said, yeah, why, it's all mucky in here. He wants to crack on, get it done, because it's not a lot. And then we can have a massive clean up after. But I don't know if any of you have seen it in previous videos or the truck in the background, but it's all started having like running rusty water. And Chris said, I've really got to do it before it starts getting quite bad. So he's absolutely stripped that back to bare metal. And he's working on that as we speak. Hopefully get that done. Get the roof painted, and that'll be another one all lovely and finished. Chris is just flattening off that guide coat, getting this all completely smooth. He's scotched the whole bonnet, literally trying to do as much as he can just to save that little bit extra when it goes to the paint shop. We have got a can of white base, so he's going to be basing up this edge, fitting the wing before it goes to the paint shop, so that all they've got to do is the bonnet, bit of A-pillar, and he's here now just finishing up, and that is the last bit. So this is pretty much going to be ready by the end of the day to go to the paint shop now, and that's another one that's going to be done. One more video after this, fitting it all back up, and it'll be completely finished and ready to put up for sale. So that is it. While I've been out on my little adventure, as you can see now, Chris has based all of that up inside there, all the way around the edge of the light. You see, it's all white there. So literally they've just got to mask it off and paint that bonnet. And then when you come around this side, you can see he's based that up there and just puffed it in up the post. So we can now get that wing fitted back on there. And that hasn't got to come off again either, so that's that bit done. Where he'd done that repair on the other side, there was a little bit in here. He's cleaned that up and done that. And then in there, it's all flatted off, and there was absolutely nothing for him to do paint-wise basing up there. They'll mask up the bumper and blend that arch straight into that quarter panel. So we really, really have put in the hours this week and got so much done already. So hopefully we get all these projects nipped up and buy some new ones. It's back from paint. We're really happy with how it turned out. And Chris is literally just going around doing all the finishing touches on the van today. So we've started by clearing it out, got all the under trays and bits and pieces that have got to go back on once it's lifted up. But if you remember, we did put this side loading door on it, but we never actually plumbed it up. We've got all the wiring here from the original one, so he's going to be putting that in. He's just gone ahead and took that module out because, as we know, the driver's airbag had gone off. We do now have the driver's airbag, and that is fitted in there. So we had to get that out because I've got to pop it over and have it reset. But the paintwork come out very, very nice. And we did fit that bumper up Saturday and didn't manage to capture it on video, but I'm sure you've all seen us chuck a bumper on before. It was quite complicated, and it was this grill that we was waiting for. It was quite hard to get. You have to buy this part separate, there's a bit behind the bumper that's separate, so. On, he's got the arch liners back in, front bumper all clipped back in its original clips, the bottom piece there. It needs three tires. One of them is actually okay, that one, but it, as you can see there, it's got a screw in it, so it's cheaper to just get a tire rather than have that puncture fixed. Them two are bald. I did notice something on this van. I will get to that in a minute. And that's about ringing things over. I also need to go and just grab that bolt that holds up that spare wheel carrier. But we'll move around to this side. That's all back in there, how it should be. New drop links. I think we did a bit of a video when we put those on. But as you will see, that is it, pretty much complete. I need to carry on and get it ready for an MOT. Chris has stripped out all of the center console and the middle seat this morning, and dropped out the module for me. I'm just going to run over to the breakers over the Isle of Sheppey, because I know that they break loads of these vans. I'm going to see if he's got three tyres for it, all matching. And while I'm there, the young lad there does restore these and takes out the crash data. I'm sure he may have to open this up and do a repair on it. It may be a case of just plugging it in, but he did say, to be honest, we can just turn up with this one and he'll swap it for one that's already been done. But it would be really nice to see him do it, because if it is a simple solder, it's something that we can do in the future. So this van, when we purchased this van, obviously we didn't go and look at it, we purchased it on pictures, but we could see that the radio had been removed and there was no aerial on the roof. But the lorry drivers do tend to take the aerials off the roof. But the more we've worked on it, the more we have noticed. This did come from a very big company that has a lot of these vans. And we've noticed that all the tyres, most of them, are odd. And they're bald. And the insurance company would not pay out if you was driving with that tyre. And that tyre was on the front of this van. So what we actually think, and that tyre as well, look, it's got a big split in it. And it's completely bald on that edge. What we actually think is that whoever had the accident in this van, the company, they actually rung all the tyres over that they've obviously had for their other vans and put all of the rubbish ones onto this van. They've also taken the stereo, thinking that that's going to be okay to use in one of their other vans. So it is a bit of a pain, but luckily there was not really anything else. The battery, if you remember, that was missing as well, and it wasn't damaged, the battery tray, so clearly they'd taken that as well. There doesn't seem to be any other bits missing, but it's still a shame that people do feel the need to do that, because what is two new tyres? 60, 70 pounds? It's ridiculous. It's not even worth doing. So far though, so good. And we should get this one buttoned up today. from the breaker's yard, Sheppey Motor Salvage. I'll put their phone number in the description. They are a Ford breakers and they do these little vans. I know them really well, been using them years. So we've got the old Hankooks tyres, quite a good make for the van, and they are all matching tyres, and as you can see, they are all like new. So I've got the three tyres, we've got the aerial, Chris has just screwed that on. The module, Matt did say I could record him doing this, but it's not something that we're ever going to be able to do because you've got to have a computer to do it. So he undone this, took off like the wax coat in there, plugged his little computer onto it, left it for about 10 minutes, come back, he said the crash data is now gone. We've also got a spare wheel hanger. So we seem to have everything we need to get this van nipped in the bud today. I will tell you the price. It was £110, but I said to him £100 for the lot, and he said yes. But don't forget, I am trade. I do use them all the time, and I've known them for years. So they do look after me. It was going to be £25 per tyre and £30 for the module. But obviously, he's chucked in the aerial, the spare wheel bit, and knocked a fiver off. So we're quite happy with that £100 for the rest of the bits. Now we can get this van all nipped up. Let's crack on and get it done.
Guys, I have come down to where I'll take the pictures. It is quite windy and there's nothing I can really do about that. So hopefully it is okay. I've just took it for a nice valet and an MOT. It's now got 12 months MOT on it. It drives really, really nice and it's turned out an absolutely lovely van. I will be going back to the yard in a minute and we're going to do the numbers on it and I will tell you the plans. As you can see, it is, you know, 2016, a work van, but it has come out really, really nice and we're happy with how it come out. Let's just jump in quickly and I'll tell you the last couple of little jobs we've got to do. It's all come up really nice and clean and tidy inside as well. So the last couple of jobs, we have temporarily put this in there, the single din for the stereo, but this is actually meant to have this stereo in it. Now we did manage to grab one of these. This stereo works perfect, but it won't stop beeping. Now we now know that we need to get that coded, and that's not a problem either. The problem we've got is there's a surround missing and it has three buttons at the top. I believe they're volume buttons and we need to get those. The other thing is the air conditioning. It doesn't actually come out, it doesn't work, so we need to get that regassed. And just little bits like cleaning that up. But apart from that, it is pretty much finished. Let's go back to the yard, crunch the numbers, and I'll tell you the exciting part that you all seem to really, really love about the builds. So we start off with initially, if you have been following this, you'll know this already, but the initial cost of the van was £1,280, and that was all in with the fees, with me collecting it. We went to the breaker's yard because we needed some bits. We did have quite a lot already, but we bought a radiator, a bonnet and a front panel, and that was £220. We also bought some bits and bobs online, fuse lid, a grill, the backing for the grill, and that was £30. A front bumper we bought new. It is pattern, but it is a very, very good fit and it is insurance approved, and that was £66. The wheel trims, again, they're pattern, but they're absolutely brilliant and they come with the stickers. £28 new from eBay. Floor mats, bought them new, £15. Two new drop links, you know, one of them was bent, or no, they was both hanging off, I think, they was knackered. £16, and that was for a pair. The battery, £20 from Kent Autos. Got a really, really good one from around there, off of a nearly new car, so that was brilliant to get that for that money. The windscreen we already had in the parts van, but we did have to pay to have it swapped out, so that was £40. The front grille surround, which we really, really struggled to get, I managed to find from a local bumper person. you know, that do these slightly damaged bumpers, and that was only £20. The other part of the grill that we had to buy that clips to was 104, which is unbelievable considering it's only a small piece, but we couldn't find one anywhere. The airbag, again, struggled to find one for that van, £130. Loads available with a Citroen badge, but none with the Peugeot badge, which is what we needed. The wheels and tyres, we said earlier, we went over and got them, they was £100. The paintwork, Chris prepped everything and got it all done. And I just want to pick up on a lot of you said, why didn't we do it? It's the mess, the bagging up, the clearing out the spray booth. For what we paid, it's just not worth it. The guy charged us £200 and it's come out like a sheet of glass. The bonnet looks lovely from here. So the MOT, normal, £40. The air conditioning regas, which I haven't had done, but I'm gonna add it on now, is £50. And the radio buttons, I haven't put a price because I'm not sure on what they are yet. So let's say the radio buttons and the aircon, the aircons, I've already put it on here. So let's add another 50 for the radio buttons. That will be £2,409. And I think that's cheap for that van, very, very cheap. And we are thinking that we're gonna ask £3,750 for it. And I think that'll be a cheap van. It's done 57,000 miles and it is really, really nice. It's not been abused at all. The thing that I did wanna just add to the end of this video, because a lot of you reached out to me in the last video, we originally got this van for Chris to upgrade from his 2012 to a 16. And then after we was getting into it, Chris said, you know what, Rob, I'm not really that bothered. I'm not really that bothered. His van's only done about 40 or 50,000 anyway. He said, it's no different. If I'm gonna upgrade, I might as well upgrade to a bigger van. So we decided that we're gonna be selling this one. So as usual now, we'll be chucking some tax on it. I'll be running around in it, sourcing the parts, using the van, doing a couple of hundred miles in it, snagging it, make sure there's nothing wrong with it. And then we'll be usually, as we normally do, putting it on Instagram, offering it to the followers on there. And then it'll, if it don't, it'll be going on the internet elsewhere for sale. But it's a nice cheap van. I'm sure it'll sell without even advertising it. So that is going to be the end of the Berlingo videos. Partner, rather, is it? No, it is a Berlingo. No, it is a Peugeot partner. I'll get there in the end. That is going to be the end of the videos on the Peugeot partner. If you do enjoy the videos, please do give us a thumbs up. We really do appreciate it and it shows your appreciation. Check out the merchandise. The link is in the description. Like, subscribe and share. Thank you all very much for watching and we'll see you very soon in the next one.